Hello, everyone. Happy Wednesday, and welcome to another week and another episode of Quandaries and Sundries. I hope you're all doing well today. I was surfing the web last night, as I do, late at night, and I saw that the Nobel Peace Prize awards are upon us again in 2 days. I thought about how I never really paid that much attention to it in my life. How I felt like it had become a political tool, that some winners didn't deserve it. So I decided to dive into the past and look at how it was founded and find some great people who have won it and share their accomplishments. So let's learn all about the Nobel Peace Prize. The year is 1888. The Swedish inventor and philanthropist Alfred Nobel, known for his work in the steel and munitions industry, and most famously known for being the man that invented dynamite, was struck with grief at the death of his brother, Ludwig. But what was more shocking was that many newspapers published that Alfred was the one who died, and the things the newspapers said about him left him brokenhearted. Although dynamite was invented for civilian purposes and was used by miners and construction workers to make it easier for them and safer for their work, the newspapers falsely claimed that they were military explosives that killed many people, and even called him the Merchant of Death. Some papers even praised his own death. It was then and there that Nobel, who tried to do something good with his dynamite, wanted to be remembered for something better. So 7 years later, a year before his death at the age of 63, he established the Nobel Peace Prize Committee, using 95% of his entire estate, worth about $500,000 in today's economy. He said himself that he wanted the award to go to those who have conferred the greatest benefit to humankind. While I am a man of science, and the idea of going over those amazing people who have won the award in chemistry and scientific achievements, I thought it would be in the spirit of Alfred Nobel himself to go over those who personified and even went beyond the very thing he sought out to build. So, let's go over a few of them today. But first, before we get back into your regularly scheduled content, if you're enjoying my content, and if you're listening on YouTube, I really appreciate if you give this video a like, a comment, and if you're new to my content, consider subscribing, because 50% of the people who watch, for some reason, have not subscribed. And don't forget to hit that little bell icon so you can be notified whenever I post something new. Or if you're listening to this on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or whatever audio platform you're listening to this on, consider giving me a follow. Any feedback is greatly appreciated. Now let's get right back into the Nobel Peace Prize. I'd like to start off with the very first winner of the Nobel Peace Prize in 1901, a Swiss man by the name of Henri Dunant, a humanitarian who, along with a fellow award winner of the same year, a Frenchman by the name of Frédéric Passy, decided that after witnessing the terrible conditions and horror at the 1859 Battle of Solferino, he said that in the future there should be a neutral organization that provides unbiased help to wounded soldiers and cares for them with the utmost respect deserving of them. And so he won the Nobel Peace Prize for founding the Red Cross, which still stands to this day, which has gone on to win the award at least 2 more times for its help in World War I and in World War II. Next, let's jump to 1964, where a man that needs no introduction, the great Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., won the award for his fight for racial equality and through using nonviolence. On the Nobel Peace Prize website, you can hear his speech, and I highly recommend looking it up. It is truly breathtaking. As a speech by this great man, he even mentioned Gandhi's method of nonviolence in his speech, which is sad because Gandhi was nominated for Nobel Peace Prize in 1937, 1938, 1939, 1947, and 1948, and sadly didn't win a single one of them. I think the great man deserved at least one. Next, as someone who was educated in a Quaker setting, my foundations come from the Quaker beliefs of simplicity, peace, integrity, community, equality, and stewardship. And I would like to highlight the Quakers, who made, with the help of the Friends Service Council and the American Friends Service Committee, won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1947 for their outstanding efforts to rescue victims from the Nazis after World War II and even before World War II. They helped over 22,000 Jewish men, women, and children escape Germany in the Holocaust and even helped them relocate to a new, better, safe life in America. Next, let's talk about the woman, the myth, the legend, and the saint herself, Mother Teresa. From her work helping the poor, to her setting up clinics to help treat leprosy, even going as far as to wash the feet of those suffering, she was a true saint and woman of the people who deserves the award in 1979. I would like to end on the youngest recipient of all time, Malala Yousafzai, a Pakistani woman who in 2014, at the age of 17, won the Nobel Peace Prize for her efforts towards education for girls and women in an oppressive regime. When it comes to women's rights, the Middle East has always been kind of a tricky subject, but she believed that all children deserved not just an education, but an equal education, a sentiment I wholeheartedly believe in. She gained an international recognition when she survived an assassination attempt that almost killed her. Her humanitarian work towards education is something we should all look up to and respect and follow. For when we truly get the education we deserve, we can make this world a better, more peaceful place worth living in and appreciating and even celebrating. And I think Alfred Nobel would be extremely proud of what he started and what it has become with these amazing human beings that truly personify the human spirit. Well, that is all I got for today. I want to thank you again for listening. Now, before I go, I would like to thank you again for joining me for another episode, and I would also love to know what you think and how I can improve the show. After all, I do the show all for you. So head over to my social media, or if you're watching the YouTube version, just the comments and let me know how I'm doing. Thanks so much, and do not forget to share this to all those in your life who could use a scientific moment in theirs. I hope you'll join me again tomorrow for another episode of Quandaries and Sundries. This is Van Masterson, signing off. Till next time.